Today we're talking hyperlapses. Roll intro. What's up, you beauties? For those of you who are new to the channel, I'm Daniel, and today we're talking about hyperlapses. Now, for those of you who don't know, this is a hyperlapse. Basically a time lapse on steroids, and it's super easy to do, and it's a great way to make your time lapses just that much better. All you have to do is introduce a little bit of camera movement when you're doing your time lapse. So let's say you've got your shots every 2 seconds. Instead of keeping the camera in one spot, start moving it back a foot every shot or forward a foot every shot. Same thing applies to a drone. So today we're going to show you how to do it on a drone and on your camera. Let's go. Method would be to take your camera or your phone or put it on a tripod and move that tripod around as you're taking your pictures in certain intervals. Move it forwards, backwards, left to right, pan, move up and down. Just make it more dynamic than completely standing still. The second way to do it is using a drone. Now, when you're using your drone, it's pretty straightforward. You only really have to consider two things. One, setting your drone to take pictures in intervals in the settings, 2, 5, 10 seconds, depending on how long you want it. And two, moving that drone. Now, when it comes to moving the drone, you set your intervals and then you can manually fly it yourself in a straight line, or you can use like a tap to fly kind of setting and just program it to fly out. And then once you're happy with the time lapse, just bring it back in. It's just that simple. So once you've got your pictures, we just have to do a quick little bit of editing in Premiere, and I'll show you how to do that right now. All right, now for the easy, but boring, but easy part. You're gonna fire up Adobe Premiere. What you're gonna do is set your sequence to whatever you want, 1920 by 1080, 4K, whatever floats your boat, you do you. And you're gonna go to import. Once you go to import, a pop-up will come up, obviously. You select the first image of the hyperlapse, and at the bottom of the window, select image sequence. It's a small little checkbox at the bottom. Make sure that's checked off, click open, and Adobe Premiere will automatically open your hyperlapse as a sequence. And all you have to do is drag it onto your timeline, color it in the way you want it, and you'll get something that looks like this. Boom, there you have it, hyperlapse. Now guys, if you liked the video and you thought it was helpful, don't forget to subscribe. And if you don't subscribe, you're gonna be stuck in traffic tomorrow. So just subscribe, just do it, man. Later.